has like a single leg, picks up my leg, like basically I have wrist control, you get in here. Sometimes it's a little bit hard, right? Usually you will grab more.
Yeah.
Then you have to be a little bit improvised and push a little confident, you eventually get your hand in. Then you sit down, and once you hit the ground with your butt, it's like a spring, you need to kick that leg up. And also use this momentum here.
A really good control, and sooner or later you will get out. Sooner or later you will get out. And now it's really great if you try to turn in this direction. This is cool. If you go to the other direction, I actually try to go to the moon. It looks like it's an open position, but actually I'm very good to try it out. And of course, I just was like, after for this statement, but I can also do it actively like that. And we just keep the wrist control, I'm very tall, like, for me, just reach over and jump down. Yeah. And sometimes even when they, you only need to have this, that's important. But don't take it crazy, because it feels like it's not dangerous at all for him. Some people just have this and they go for the takedown. You don't even notice this until you go serious. And of course, you can also pull him down and then take it. Just sit down.
Now, of course, you can get up, it's perfect, but most people will turn towards you the first step to push your arm. And that's also a variation that I like. It's like a kind of line to move with the other leg. But it's not going to practice this because there's not enough space to make it. But just for you to know that it's possible. Just jump in. You can end up really controlled. But just try the first two variations. Now I'm going to show how to get to the same position, but a completely different way by passing the guard. Like, exactly. If it's a sit-up guard, it's even easier. Keep on like forward and catch the wrist, and this is like really easy, but usually it doesn't work so easy. But if they do a sit-up guard, just jump in.
Yeah, do the same again. Because here's when you rule, if I don't do it strong enough, it wasn't, then I'm quite fucked up. Actually, I'm still not fucked up, but it's dangerous, it's dangerous.
And the other one is against the playing guard, like open guard. This is a bit harder. You have to really like force on this arm. And then lay on this one, and you need always at least one point of control to the ground. And that's why it's advanced class, because you need a nice move. And don't fall on his head, don't fall on his chest. I mean, if it's a competition, you can fall on his head, but it's even not good, because if I fall, I have to do it gently. If I fall here, it's bad for him, it hurts him, but if he's quick, maybe this arm will go to my belt, and he will probably get my back by sneaking in under me. I just try to get the leg there. That's not good. That's why you should really aim to land behind his head, but also not too far. Don't do this, because it's like too much space. It's very risky. You can still maybe make it, but try to really land close to his head. And for practicing reason, you can like put your head in front of your head and run to the left, so the guy who tries it will not hurt you, and they can just easily practice. You can also push him a little bit to the side, you just need to get the hand to the ground. Exactly. For example, go down, get this here. Now we are in the same position. And stay here, and try also this. You should try out this a little bit. Try to move to the left, to the right, and just try to block you again. Till I get up. Yep, one more time. So, yeah. You should also don't wait too long, because if it's like this, it's too late. Just wait for him and just...
For example, this would be like the perfect situation behind his back.
But as long as you're not too far, it's just enough if you're close and just stretch his arms and then just slowly get up.
Okay, let's try this. And be careful when you jump. Like when he does a sit-up guard. It's the same, just even easier, because just fall back, so you can eventually catch the head. Okay, let's try.
Okay, so this thing, especially for beginners, they will wonder why it's on here, but for example, the normal human is like this, right? But many times, for example, you are guys on your job, you just recover there, put this, like, go a bit more steady. So you end up often in this position. You want to push your arms, you want to go back. This like all the time. Yeah? You keep this and eventually you have to, the fight you have to make in fight for this, you make, have to defend, and at some point it will give you a lot of pressure with the shoulder and want to pass the ring, put this arm here to perform, like, yeah, exactly. And once he does that, you have to do a circle around him.
It's actually a little bit hard, I hope you will all get it.
You need to slowly do this, and once you get to here, you need to do it to this. When you do the twist, you also stretch your arms out.
That way you can sweep almost anybody, except if he's like twice your size.
Okay, back. Yeah, here. But also if you happen not to sweep, if you go like all the way, and you just go face there, but you just get stuck, and it doesn't work, you still can try to take the back. But just rolling up.
This is like every time it fails, you can always still try to take it back. Because this works like this. When he wants to pass, he will push with his shoulder. And if this shoulder is pushing, the sweep is working. But if he's very experienced, maybe knows the sweep, there will be like one moment, he's pushing, and then, oh shit, I'm getting sweep. And he's like getting stable. In this moment, the sweep can take you back. Because he has to like at least stay for a half second. Like solid, you have to move up. We're gonna just try to do the first one.
So now here, first pass, and I stretch my arms. And you get here.
Try this at first, like, especially for the beginners, it's not an easy movement. You have to like move your hip all the way to here.
And once you reach like the maximum, you do like an explosion and
stretch your arms also. This way you can turn them and get up. Okay, let's try. We don't know many different methods to get to here.
But if you get up, of course, you know the Mura kind of things. Let's try something here. Let's try the one that thinks that a lot of you to it's a little bit different. Put all your weight on the shoulder, basically like this. And you stretch out your arm. It's not like the typical Mura, you go behind it. You just lift this elbow and put all the pressure on it.
Just the easy submission is many people don't know.
Okay, that's the first percent. Get up. No, you're already in the right position. Just get the weight a little. Turn the wrist in and pull the elbow up and push it with the bone.
Let's try this for a couple minutes. Easy move. So. Try something else. Try the one arm tomorrow. But the thing is, people think this doesn't work. But it doesn't work if you hurt like this, because you just can stretch his arm and you eventually lose it. You have to put it really close to his hand. It's much stronger. Yeah, see, it's much harder for you to get out. And maybe even the wrist lock is close. We are here. And maybe he's raised up, maybe he's holding onto his belt or whatever. Yeah, and you can just can't get it. And his head should be free. Oh yeah, maybe he's even managed to get his hands together, which is even worse. But his head is free, so he can just go here. Now you put him into a very shitty position. Also be careful with this, it's a bit dangerous. Because you have like pulling in this direction is a kimura, and pulling in this one is like inverse of guilty. It's like breaking his neck. It feels horrible. And many people just tap because they think they are dying. Or if he doesn't tap, at least it will shock him, and then maybe he can still get the kimura. Yeah. Maybe he can even connect your... You can see it, I'm gripping with my right hand, my left elbow, the gi. It's like perfect control. You can kimura and his neck. One of the two will make him tap sooner or later.
Okay. Once again. It didn't work. Switched.
You can also use his gi. This is also interesting, especially for the gi. It's a very good control. He doesn't even know what's going on. He thinks that I'm maybe still using both hands. He doesn't know that his hand is free. So you can also do other things, like for example, go up.
Go for a choke.
Just an option.
Take your head.
fully hooked there. So you can really tight here so he doesn't get his arm off.
And you try to get the hook in, and I'll just slowly go back. And also try to push down here at the same time. Like, so lock his arm and his neck, and it's like really, it feels like you're fucking dying. Yeah? And also there's a little wrist lock here as well, another one. You just push down your arm. Yeah? But don't try it, just try it. Yeah? Okay, let's go. Sometimes they are very flexible, probably he's not, but just in case they are, you can try to go here. Still keep that arm here. Still you have to do the same thing with the head. Lay down on him. And also this leg, should be close to his arm, or maybe he will just pull out. Here you got the arm, for some reason maybe he's super flexible and he's getting up and you just, and you don't want to let him roll you, because then maybe you still finish him, but it gets risky if you get if he gets on top. So instead, just go back, put this arm here, put his legs together. Best would be behind the elbow, but in the gi usually you can squeeze enough. It's okay. I'll put my hand here. Arm here. Also, it doesn't matter if his arm is here. It just doesn't matter. Just take a grip and lay down on his head, squeeze together and turn. Just, I mean, imagine if he was flexible. Should go like till here. That works quite well against flexible people. Yeah. Also pushing into him so he doesn't turn me. See, if he's turning to this side, still submitting. Very strong. You can try this one. Time is running out. Maybe I also show the next one. Because sometimes, for example, when he's like super flexible guy and his legs are coming in all the time, and you have to just sacrifice your position. You get to here, maybe he's holding on. You go here, and maybe he's one of those who don't escape but try to take my back as well. He'll bring his legs in. Yeah, and before this happens, you just go here. Just keep pushing. You get into a very weird position, which is actually still submitting. Sometimes I'm standing. Just to get your idea how this happens. Like I go for the Himura, maybe it's too quick on the man on my back, and I just sit down.
You have to really push, like you're pushing your hands, on the, his hand on the ground, and all your weight goes in this direction, and you turn towards the left.
Yeah, see, it's like a very, many people don't know this, but it's hard to defend actually, because nobody knows it. It's like the one thing you can sometimes try. So again, for the first one.
Can you show to the other side?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
Turn around.
Good the jump.
So I'm here. I get to here. Pushing into him so he can't do much. In my leg.
This one.
And the other one. Like, it's very surprising. Go up here. And it looks like he will get my back, but I just
go here and push down. I need to be very tight to really fight this for my life, because I'm sacrificing like all my control just for the submission, and also pushing into it. Yeah, I'm really pushing it like segregate. It's like this. Normally, you just push his hands down. Yeah, what's up? Okay. Try this one. And the first one, okay? You can do so much more with this, like impossible to try everything in 1 hour.
So I'm just gonna show a couple little things to keep you thinking. For example,
up to my side now. The kimura is not just a thing with the hands. Yeah? It can be like this. Of course, it doesn't happen often, but it can sweep in, it can submission. This is, for example, a kimura. I think all I get is called the thrill. You can also do this shit. Just like an example, and also lay down.
Sometimes when I'm rolling, just take the arm and push like this. It feels like slow. I mean, if it's like a real fight, you can just go home and break it. But usually you use it to make it roll. And what would you do? You roll, roll, right? Roll, roll, roll.
Then you get, for example, an armbar. You need to use the kimura like, it's not just this, you know? That's what they always show, what kimura is. But kimura is just rotating the arm in this direction. You can do it from everywhere. It's really
super effective. You can do it with your legs, you can use it for so many things, for example, not only set up.
This happens a lot. I just stretch it out and it looks crazy, but it's not even so hard, even with heavy people, because you use all these muscles here and you can turn them around and do it again for an armbar. So that's all I wanted to show. Just keep trying, keep experimenting with the Kimura. It's a great move. So that's it. I hope you liked it.
Yeah.
Maybe do a picture before the next class starts. So that's it. Awesome.